say a few words.
Nashukuru kipeo, asante. Asante ni sana. Once again, as you all know, I have been here before. Hopefully this is for the last time. Fellow Kenyans, let me say that today, Tuketi, that today I, as a Kenyan, celebrate our resilience as a nation, but I also celebrate our resilience and the resilience of our democracy, the resilience of our people, and also the resilience of our institutions. Any other country experiencing the turns and twists of our recent electoral process would have burst asunder. But our Kenyan resilience will not tire. It will not give in to obvious provocations and base invitation to the politics of darkness. But for this blessing of reason, long-suffering and passion for country, I take this opportunity to thank God. He has brought us thus far, and he will give us victory over darkness. On the 8th of August, and I will not tire to say so, Kenyans woke up early and peacefully to vote. And on that date, they voted me, their president, without a doubt. When my victory was put to test at the Supreme Court, this was the verdict. The court did not challenge my overwhelming mandate of 54%. The numbers were never questioned. What the court questioned was the process of declaring my victory. And because the court did not question my victory, they, by extension, with their ruling, validated my 54% numbers. And herein began a political paradox. In spite of this paradox, I had to make a very painful decision. The choice for me was to resist the paradox and insist on my valid victory, or to submit myself to the rule of law. This was a very difficult and painful decision, but I had to make it. But in that, and in my own reflections, I was reminded that the law is greater than me. Indeed, it is greater than any individual. And that the law is a direct expression of the general will of all. And with this painful reasoning, I submitted myself to the general will as expressed through our Constitution. And this is how The October 26th election was made possible. It is an expression, fellow Kenyans, of the general will of all. And this general will included the right to vote, but also the right not to vote. The road to October 26th was not easy. Indeed, our own parliament, comprising our Senate and National Assembly, as the lawmaking organ of our nation, took the legislative critique by the Supreme Court seriously, and they embarked to correct the legislative challenges to our election laws. But when the bill was brought to me for signature as president, I was also compelled by my own conscience to go back to the origins of law. If an act of parliament is a direct expression of the will of the people, are the people happy with the law? Some, including some in this room, argued that I was changing the rules of engagement halfway through the game. Others argued that to change the electoral law ahead of the 26th election was to privilege myself over the other competitors. And because the law must be founded on reasoned national consensus, I listened to these voices. And I did not sign that new bill into law. Fellow Kenyans, the rule of good law does not discriminate. It gives us the right to act and the right not to act. The right to vote and equally the right not to vote. But it gives us another fundamental condition. It gives us the opportunity to choose and impose on us the results of choice. Fellow Kenyans, despite the fact that my major competitor went to court demanding that the presidential election be nullified and was actually granted his pleading and an annulment, he chose to ignore the rest of the ruling, which ordered a fresh election in 60 days, conducted by none other than the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission as constituted. Therefore, he ultimately chose to abandon the fresh poll. I say this, you cannot choose the opportunity to exercise a right and therefore and thereafter abscond from the consequences of that choice. In line with the verdict, I chose to abide by the court ruling. I went back to our people and once again appealed for their vote. And I take this opportunity to thank all those who turned up in these fresh polls. All those who turned up despite violent intimidation and witchcraft. Many Kenyans exercise their democratic rights. The narrative so far, locally and internationally, therefore, that voter turnout was low is inaccurate. It is nothing but a consistent history of political convenience and a tirade of conjecture statistics that some of us have continued to exercise. Fellow Kenyans, herein is the truth. As recorded in our books and shall be recorded in our history. On the 8th of August, 15 million Kenyans came out to vote. Of these, 8.4 million Kenyans voted for me. On October 26th, 90% of those same voters came out once again to support my bid. This was nothing more than a revalidation of their general will, a statement of their national intent in support of myself and in support of our Jubilee government, which was their choice. And all of this was done within the confines of the rule of law and our constitutional imperatives. For those who voted for me and Jubilee, by way of revalidating our August 8th victory, today I thank you. Now we can begin the process of reimagining our nationhood. But as we do so, I must remind you of my commitment to the constitutional path and the rule of law. Put differently, my victory today is just part of a process that is likely to once again be subjected to a constitutional test through our courts. And as I have demonstrated repeatedly, I will submit to this constitutional path no matter its outcomes. Fellow Kenyans, if we are to remain committed to constitutionalism, the rule of law, respect for independent institutions, and respect for human life, our democratic resilience will be assured. And this is my personal commitment to the general will of all. And because I will not be answering any questions, as I've said, this is an ongoing process. The people of Kenya have decided. The IEBC have made their announcement as to the verdict in a free and fair democratic election. There is still another process. So we shall wait for that process and we shall wait for its outcome. So therefore, those who will want to ask me, are you going to engage in dialogue with so and so and so and so, let them first and foremost exhaust their constitutionally laid out processes. Let them go to court, let them do whatever they want. Nobody shall deny them of their constitutional right. Those issues we shall discuss later. As to my agenda going forward, I will discuss once the processes are over. I am not going to jump the gun. Secondly, as we ponder over the next few days, my first preoccupation as it has been for the last few days, is with our 1.6 million young people who have spent 4 to 8 years preparing for their secondary and primary school exams. The future of these children should not be disrupted, irregardless of our political concerns. And my commitment is to ensure that even as we await the final political outcome, that our exams will continue as scheduled and that the future of our children is guaranteed. My last appeal is the appeal I have consistently made to all Kenyans. Your neighbor will remain your neighbor despite the political outcomes. Your neighbor will be your brother. Your neighbor will be your sister. Let each and every one of us be our brother's keeper, our sister's keeper. Let us maintain peace. And with that, I say, God bless Kenya, and God bless our resilience. Asante ni sana wenzangu. Asante.
Thank you.